Hey everyone, I'm Daniel from LAND Software, and in this video I'll show you how to create a curved ramp between the stories of an existing building using LAND4 objects and tools. So I will create a ramp from the ground floor up to the first floor. To do that, I will use spot levels to define the areas from where to start and where to end, and ridge lines to control the surface which will represent the ramp. So my building ground floor starts or has an elevation of 30 meters, while the first floor has 33 meters. Therefore, because I'll use spot levels to construct this ramp, I will just place two spot levels in each corner of the entrance. I can also do it in the 3D view, so I just input the 30 meters, and then I simply need to click it in the model. If I go to the ground floor, I can see the spot level has updated and it's been placed in the right location. I'm using the trace function, therefore I can follow all the stories of the building. I can now continue placing the spot levels also in the plan view, so I know the elevation is 30 meters and I have the trace, so I can place it in the location. As you can see in the 3D view, the spot levels are now shown in the corners and I can also make a selection of them. So I just need to place them also on the other entrance. So I'll make sure I choose the reference from the first story. Here I can see the entrance in the building, and now I just need to add 33 meters in each corner. Now that I place my spot levels at the entrance of each story, I can continue building the ramp. So back to plan view, I can start by maybe placing a spline. So I start from one of the spot levels and I just continue drawing the shape of the ramp. I make sure I click on the other spot level, and now I can maybe make some adjustments to the line. And once I'm happy with its shape, I can also use the polyline tool to place a polyline on top of it and use the polyline instead of the spline, but you can use both lines. Now that I have the line selected, I can copy paste it and offset it to all ridges for 2 meters. And that's the width of the entrance, and make sure I close the line on the spot levels. Now that I have the polylines, I'm ready to transform them into 3D lines. So I select it and press on Create Ridge Line, and I just need to click on each spot level and press the green mark. Can do the same for the other one. And now if we go in the 3D view, we can visualize the lines. And as you can see, they follow the polyline we have drawn, and they meet the spot levels at the entrance in the building. Here on this side, we can have a fall, for instance, so I can always add new spot levels to the ridge line. So I can have first a fall and then maybe continue with a raise towards the first floor. To do that, I can use the initial spot level. But before, maybe I'll draw some help lines along the ramp. So I could have maybe 3 lines. And I will use the initial spot level to interpolate another one. And I will use a fall percentage of maybe 3% and simply place it on the line. I'll do the same on the other side. So now we have new spot levels with a fall. We can continue the interpolation, and this time I can have maybe a raise of 5% to the next one. So this is just a simple way on how to add spot levels to your ridge line using some basic interpolation tools. In this way, it's very easy to control your 3D lines or your surfaces. I can now delete the help lines. And if we go into 3D view, we can now visualize these spot levels. And as you can see, they are not yet part of the line. So I can now add them to the line. So I just need to select them and press on the function button called Add Spot Level to the Ridge Line. You can do the same for the other one. And back to the 3D view, we can now see the lines are adjusted. So they contain also the new spot levels I've just added. In this way, it's just very easy to control your 3D lines and therefore your surface. Once I have my lines, I can now use the create land surface function, and using the magic wand, I simply create the land surface. We also have the level lines on, and we can also see the 3D object. So as you can see, it just follows the ridge lines and the spot levels along. I can also add the level lines in the 3D view, and I use a height distance of 50 millimeters in between the lines. So this is just an easy way on how to create your own 3D objects in ARCHICAD using LAND4 tools. With the help of the spot levels and the ridge lines, you can create complex land surfaces on which you have control over the thickness. So in this video, we have constructed a curved ramp between the story of an existing building using LAND4 objects and tools. For more videos, visit our YouTube channel or landforcad.com.